Play day, you already know the vibes.
Boy, what the f-? You lying. No, 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 y'all hit me, y'all hit me, y'all hit. What is he doing in the front seat?
Nah, oh my. Bro. I saw you hit them, bro.
Not you again.
You still ain't got
no, bro, they hit me, they hit me, bro. Look, he crying because they know he did it. Are you serious? It's the front side, we cannot change the fate of civilization.
What's going on, guys? It's Tronage here, coming at you with the top 5 worst mega elixirs in Black Ops 4 Zombies. Quickly before the video begins, if you could give me a subscribe, ring the bell, like, and leave a comment with some decent criticism, that'd be all appreciated. Also, at the top right of the screen, I'm going to leave tags to recent Black Ops 4 Zombie content that I've made, and the Black Ops 4 Why It's Better Than Vanguard series, or my playlist series in general, at the top right of the screen. So if you guys could go check out that content if you not have already, that would be much appreciated. But anyways, on with the video now. Coming in at the number 5 spot is wall-to-wall clearance, a 30-second wall-by fire sale. And generally speaking, this is not a very useful elixir, considering that, you know, well, fire sales and other types of elixirs already kind of do this, and wall buys are not really that expensive, so I don't know why you would, you know, ever need a fire sale for wall weapons of all things. So this one's definitely the most redundant out of the bunch. Coming in at the number 4 spot is Control Z. Basically the turned alternate ammo type turned into elixir. This one's not very useful because, as I just mentioned, the fact that, well, if brain rot or turned is in the game, why would I ever use this as an elixir? It's not really that useful. If you're trying to get something to cover you in an Easter egg or a specific thing you're trying to do in the map, I guess it's useful. But generally speaking, it's just not one of those ones that I would ever want to use. Especially considering, like, a lot of the classic gobblegums, or elixirs, my bad, are just generally better. So, it doesn't make much sense to use this one out of the bunch anyways. Coming in at the number 3 spot is Blood Debt. This one is generally not good because of the fact that, well, there's one elixir in the rare category that this one is also in that does a lot better of a job. It basically protects you from going down and takes extra hits, but it sacrifices your points. You can kind of see why this one's not really good, considering, like, you know, the other elixir that's in its very same class can also beat it, which I'm not going to name off. And it wastes points, so it's not really going to actually help you in the long run, unless if you're in, like, those really high rounds. And at that point, wouldn't you rather just save those points in case if you go down to buy stuff? You can kind of see why this one, like, it sounds good in practice, but it just fails in the execution. So, definitely don't use this one. Coming in at the number 2 spot is Phantom Reload. This elixir allows you to get a 30% chance to refill your entire magazine without using your stock of ammo. It lasts for 4 minutes, and a lot of the time I've heard from many people, it doesn't even work half the time, so that's not really good as it is. And the 30%, that may sound like it may activate every once in a while, but from the testing that I've gathered, it barely activates at all. And this is a common elixir, might I add, so if it was in any other tier, it would be number 1. But considering it's a common and it can't even do its job, you know, I don't think I really have to explain why not to use this one. Especially because there's perks like Bandolier Bandit and stuff that already kind of do this stuff a lot better, so it just makes more sense just not to run this one. And finally, coming in at the number one spot. And the most useless epic in the entire game is Suit Up. This elixir allows you to get 100% armor when you use it for the first time. And then every other time you always get 100% armor as well. You can kind of see why this one's not very useful because, well, the armor you can also get from specialist weapons and other types of things like talismans, like battered dragon scale and other things like that. So why would I ever waste my time using an elixir to get full armor? Especially because this is an epic elixir. This is one of the rarest ones. And every time I ever got this inside of the factory, I always sighed every time because I knew that this one is not really that useful. So, generally speaking, it's just better to just never use it because there's talismans and other types of things in the game that just replace it entirely. Even the shields in the game, so it's just like, what's the point, you know? The only point I could ever see you ever using this for is like a no shield challenge or something. And you know, the fact that it's an epic and you know, no one uses it because of this fact just solidifies that it's just that terrible. Like, I've never seen anyone use this thing. And that's because, well, it's not useful for anything. Simple fact. Anyways, guys, that's going to be it for the video. Please remember to subscribe, like, ring the bell, and leave a comment with some decent criticism on the video down below. And remember to please check all of the tags that I left at the top right of the screen for other types of content that you could find related to this topic and many more. And I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.